What is the state of Egypt and Cairo right now?
Well, you know, we just got an update literally a few minutes ago saying that the Muslim Brotherhood, which is effectively the major opposition party, the party that was essentially attacked yesterday, well, the Muslim Brotherhood is calling for mass protests and a series of mass funerals that are expected to take place later this afternoon. So there, the city is clearly on edge. We're living under martial law right now. There's a curfew that takes place in the evening. No one has any idea whether or not the Muslim Brotherhood and its supporters are even going to obey the curfew. So to say the city is on edge, yes, that's absolutely true. And just walking around downtown Cairo, you know, at this time of day, it would be bumper to bumper. There would be tourists out. There would
right.
be boats on the river. There is nothing right now.
Muhammad, you've been definitive on this in your academics at Toronto and Columbia. This time is different. You know it's about the weekends. It is Thursday. How do we get to next Monday?
Well, you know, the big concern, obviously, in the Middle East, and you know this as well, is Friday afternoon. Friday afternoon, you're going to have the weekly services that the Muslim Brothers will attend. There will likely still be some funerals to be held tomorrow afternoon. You get much larger crowds. You get people coming in from the villages to the main cities, and there is a real danger there that today and certainly tomorrow are going to be a tinderbox. And I got to be honest with you, it's not going to take a whole lot to set off these crowds, because these are people who have already lost loved ones, already lost friends, and quite frankly, they're furious.
Well, you just referenced the funerals. We've been watching live pictures out of Cairo all morning long, and we believe that we have a picture actually of the mosque where people are gathering, where there are supposed to be funerals held today for the people that have died in the violence, Mohammed. What do you see in terms of any type of resolution, and how is this different from the other outbursts that we've been seeing on television in Egypt, unfortunately, over the last few months and years?
You know, I got to say, up until yesterday, up until the live bullets started firing yesterday, as much as people weren't talking about it, there was always a hope there that there could have been some political resolution. We saw this even, you know, in Egypt's interim vice president, Mohamed El-Bardeh, who was considered a key U.S. ally. He was hopeful right up until the end that there could be a political resolution. Once he resigned, that put the nail in the coffin, and it essentially means the Muslim Brothers are not going to back down, and we've seen that the military is not going to back down. So I think right now there is no talk of any kind of political resolution at all. It's more about, hey, how bad is it going to get?
Mohammed, you talk about the violence, we're getting more violence. What is the talk about spillover into other parts of the Middle East?
Well, I mean, here's the thing, right? Egypt is one of the most influential countries in the Middle East. It's the most populous country in the Middle East. Egyptians typically travel around the Middle East to other countries. What's happening now is that we have anti-Americanism here in Cairo. I got to say, listen, I've been to Cairo many times. I've never seen the amount of anti-Americanism here as high as it currently is. So you've got people who are furious with America. You've got the Muslim Brotherhood that, you know, and by all accounts, legitimate election being forced out of power. They're turning to the United States and saying, you know what?
Right.
What's going on here? How come no one's helping us? And because of that, there is a lot of anti-Americanism, and there's a likelihood that, you know, people will start targeting Americans, not just in Egypt, but, you know, easy American targets in the Middle East
are
hard to find. So that is a big concern right now.
Mohammed, thank you so much.